Hello, my name is Pooja and today I'm going to demonstrate about data entities in Dynamics 365 Finance and Operations. In Dynamics 365, the data entity is a new object which is launched. The purpose of this data entity is to denormalize the tables. In Dynamics 365, by default, the tables which we have, they all are in the normalized form. But as per the business requirement, if we need to convert it to denormalized form, so for that we can use data entities. Once we create data entity, that data entity we can use it in X++ code the way we use normal tables. Data entity we can access through the OData URL, and data entities we can also use in data management platform for importing and exporting data. Whenever we create data entity, the first we have to define its type, that what type of data entity we are going to create it. There are various types are available like parameter, reference, master, document, transactions. And as per the behavior of our table, we have to select these types. Like for example, if we have any table which containing these setup details, we should select parameters. If there is a table which defines the business process, like unit, dimension table, text code tables, currency tables, we should select references. If we have any table which is a root table like customer, vendor, project, we should select master. And if we have a table which is a worksheet table which in future is going to use for the transaction like sales order, purchase order, open balance, journal, so we should select document. And if we have any table which contains the posted transactions, then we should select transaction type. Now we'll see that how we create data entities in Dynamics 365 Finance and Operations. So for creating a data entity, I'll right click on my project, add new item. I'll go to the data models and pick data entity, and I rename it as my data entity. From here, the first we have to select a primary data source which is related to multiple tables. So let's say FM customer, I'm going to select it. From here, you have to define the categories. Next, enable public API. If you want to use this data entity by using OData, then you have to click on this checkbox. If you want to use this data entity for in a data management platform, then you have to select this checkbox. Data entities, we can secure it through user. So for that, it provides us privilege, which we have to assign to role, and then that role we can assign to users. Next. Once we click next, it will show you the column which is available in this table. So you can select all or you can select the specific columns. When you click on this arrow, it will show you the related table. So this table has a relationship with this primary address. You can click on that. So it will show you the column of this one. So either you can select all or you can select a specific column. Once you're done, just click on finish. Once we finish, you can see my data entity is created. I double click on that. And if I go to the fields, so you will see I'm getting all the fields from my FM customer table and all the fields from my primary address table. Now, if I can write a code, I can make a buffer of this particular data entity, and through that buffer, I can call these columns the way I call normal table. So this is the way we create data entities in Dynamics 365 Finance and Operations. Thank you for watching this video.